This experiment is called the Red Bead Experiment, and it was initially developed and promoted by Dr. Edward Deming in his business seminars. And what he did was he wanted to show the business executives who attended his seminar about how if you have a system or process that's very variable, then it doesn't matter what the workers are doing, you're going to always have variation in your results. So what you're going to do is you have a bigger bin of beads here, and you pour the beads slowly into the smaller bin, pour all the beads out, and then you take the smaller bin and pour it slowly into the bigger bin, like so, okay? Using only one hand. It doesn't matter if you use your right or left hand, but you can only use one hand. Then you take the paddle, like this, put it in the beads. Make sure all of the beads cover the paddle. It's very important that all the beads cover the paddle. Lift the paddle up 4 inches from the beads. Tilt the paddle at a 34 degree angle, like so. So make sure that there's a bead in each one of the holes. So once you have all of the beads in the paddle, walk slowly over to the inspectors, okay? And you inspectors, you need to count how many red beads there are. Because sometimes we have, in this process, red beads that get into the production, which are not good. Those are defects. And so the inspectors will notify us of the defects. So I am the manager, and I will be trying to coach you and give you encouragement throughout the day. Our goal is to produce, for every paddle, no more than 3 red beads, okay? So we have you, each of you have a target, no more than 3 red beads in when you do this, okay? You can see from the experiment that when students, in our case, dip the paddle into the bin and pull out some beads, they're always going to have some red beads. And so when I am playing the managerial role and I'm telling a student you're not doing a good enough job or praising a student for not getting very many red beads, it really doesn't have any effect in terms of how they actually perform in that experiment because there are so many red beads in the bin that they're always going to pull up some red beads. And what they're doing actually doesn't have any impact in terms of how many red beads they're pulling up. It's just a very variable process. And so it teaches the students to look for variation in the process. And what you really need to do is you need to fix the process or fix the system, and it's not the blame or responsibility of an individual worker. I think this is a fun way to begin the class in IE 561, Total Quality Management, because it gets the students involved in an activity where they're getting their hands in. It involves a lot of students who get to participate and play different roles. They get to see me in a kind of fun way playing the bad manager. So it's a fun activity that gets the students involved. But I think it also shows an important learning element that we continue to talk about during the class, and that is the importance of variation, the importance the variability and the importance of really understanding your process and the system as a whole rather than focusing on specific individual components or in this case specific individual workers. So that's a common theme that develops throughout the rest of the course in this semester.